And my favorite word at 5 years old is the F word. Rhymes with luck. Okay, we all know. Okay. And so I'm saying all this, these words to my parents, to my teachers, to the assistant teacher, to the principal, you know, the very bad word, being very aggressive and standing up to him and saying these words to him. Well, I eventually get kicked out of kindergarten because of my very aggressive behavior, whether it was punching the teacher, kicking the teacher, biting the teacher, the assistant teacher, or using this profanity-laced language. So, I'm now back at home. I'm spending a few weeks at home. And my mom tells me to come in to play. I mean, come in from playing, come inside. And I proceed to tell her off with a very bad language. And she says to me, "You will never use that word again. Come in here." And she's so angry. And as I walk inside the house, I see yellow Coors beer cans everywhere. And she proceeds to yell at me. And she grabs me. And she pulls me upstairs. And I don't know what's about to happen. But as I go upstairs, I'm holding on to the black iron banister, going, "No, Mom, no, Mom, what's going on?" What? You know, I'm screaming. And then she takes me upstairs to the bathroom. And she proceeds to turn on the hot water in the sink. And I still don't know what's going on, but she says, "You're going to end up like your dad. You're a bad kid. You're a bad kid." And she keeps yelling at me, and all I can remember is steam. Smoke steam, you know, I thought it was smoke, but steam. I'm 5 years old. She keeps telling me how bad of a person it is, and then she proceeds to put my left hand and hold it and hold it and hold it. And as she's doing that, I look in the reflection of the mirror and see her behind me holding this hand that I cannot overpower. And I see the angriest person I've ever seen. Well, eventually, she takes my hand out, and my skin peels off. It's just pink. Just peels off. But not only that day did she burn my hand, she burned into my heart, to my soul, and to my mind that, yes, I was a bad kid. So that was the downhill roller coaster ride that started, because now I believed I was bad. It had been burned into me. But now, it took a special foster home to take me. It wasn't a normal foster home that's going to take a kid that's out of control. My mom is very religious. And before I even came to that foster home, she woke up one day praying on her knees. And as she got up, she looked on the side of her bed, and there I was. She had never met me. She had never seen me. But as soon as I walked into her house to meet her, she had already seen me. She knew that she was supposed to have me. My foster parents later realized at 8, 9 years old that I was not mentally handicapped, that I was a sponge, that I started learning to read, arithmetic, everything because they spent time with me. That is the biggest issue, if I can tell you one thing, is the time. Because when I was suspended a lot from first, second, and third grade, I was at home a lot. And so my mom just sat with me and helped me learn to read, helped me learn to do arithmetic, all that stuff. It's the time. So many foster kids feel like they're in a storage area, this warehouse, right? This is, well, you're getting a check, $500, $400, $600, whatever. You're getting the check, and so they just stay in their room. But it's the time. And do you know the number one thing that foster kids want? You know what love to them is? Listening. That's all they, because they're always used to people telling them, but no one's listening to them. So, my foster parents started listening to me. Now, what they later discovered is Derek is pretty smart. And Derek knows how to do music. Derek has this gift of music. And so they started putting me in these creative programs of music.
Do I scare you? Can you look me in my eyes and tell me that you want me here? Do you want to know my name? I'm just a kid with pain. Well, I got one life. Will you help me live it right? You can be the most important person in my life. If you would just save me, then I would be grateful. If you'd save me, and I would be grateful. So you found me in the middle of a world that didn't even want me here. So why'd you pick me? Can't even love trust or have feelings. Well, I bet you believe in something in me that I can't see in me. You could be my mom and dad, oh, you could love me if you would just say. You would just save me, and I would be grateful. I've been a rebel, going out like Jesse James. I poured the whiskey out, 'cause it didn't stop my pain. Yeah, I took a deep breath and put out my last cigarette. 'Cause you gave me meaning in life when I was so close to death. Mom, Dad, you saved me. You saved me. I want to thank you. You saved me. I want to thank you.